Hello students, welcome to the third lecture of your thermodynamic course. In the previous lecture, I have given you the concept of system, surrounding and boundary, and we have described three different systems. One is open, closed and isolated system. In this system, we will see the properties of the system, the properties which are the characteristic of the system, which define the state of the system. Like if you we have got a system, how we define the system? Using some variables, and those variables are as a properties. So it only depends on the state of the system, that we'll see in the later of this lecture. And then but it doesn't depend on the whatever the path it has followed. So basically we got two different types of categories of properties. One is intensive properties, the intensive properties which do not depend on the mass of the system, like we got the example as temperature and pressure. Then we got the extensive properties which do depend on the mass of the system. So we got a intensive property, temperature, pressure. If you have a room, if you divide your room in two spaces, so in two parts, so whatever the pressure, there is there any going to be any changes in one part, or changes in pressure or temperature in one part and another part? The temperature is going to be remains, and if it is 30 degree before the partition, it will be the same in each part of the system. Similarly, pressure will be going to be remain the same. So it doesn't depend on the mass, because the now mass is reduced to half. However, the extensive property does do depend on the mass, because if you make the partition, then what happened to the volume? The volume will also got reduced to the half. So that is the extensive property. And but you can, what you can do, like you can from extensive property you can get intensive property of that particular property of the particular variables. So how can it got that? If you divide that extensive property by the mass of the system, then you got the intensive property of the properties. So here if you take volume here, and if you divide the volume with the mass of the system, then you got the intensive property. This is as a specific volume. We give a different name for that intensive property, that we for volume we take say as a specific volume. And normally the uppercase letters are used to denote the extensive property, where the exceptions are there, that is the mass. And in case of and lowercase letters are normally used to express the intensive property. Here also there is two exceptions, one is pressure, another is temperature. Now we'll see that what is the state of the system. So from the state you can got to know that this is the condition of the system. So whatever the system is as the, there is the system is as a mass, or is called is the finite amount of quantity, or the specific region in space. So that system, whatever the condition of the system, is the state. So how we know the condition of the system? So there should be some properties associated with the system, so it has to define the, using that properties we got to know the state of the system. So the definition is the state is the condition of the system at any instant of time as described or measured by its properties. So obviously its unique condition of a system is called a state. So and in every state the properties have identical values. So from that we can see whether a variable can be termed as a property or not. So for that, if you see that we can see the two, we can make two different tests for that. So a variable can be a property if and only it got a single value at its equilibrium state, or a variable can be a property if and only if the change is state gives the a value of the property whatever the, if you have difference in value, that will be a single value. So if you got a some unique value for initial state, and if you got a some unique value for the final state, whatever the difference, that will be a single value. That should not be like you can get a different value for like for going from one state to another state. You going for the another state, whether you different paths, whether you going to a different process, but you are reaching your initial state and the end states are they are equal. If the end states and final states are fixed, so whatever the difference in values you will got for a variable, that will be a single value, then it can that variable is can be termed as a property. So any variable whose change is fixed by the end state is a property. And for this idea is a state postulate, which is that for a simple compressible system we need two independent intensive property to define the state of the system. That is a state postulate. Now we'll see that as we see that thermodynamics, what we learn is only deals with the equilibrium states. So what do you mean by the equilibrium state? So the term equilibrium, what do you mean is a thermodynamic equilibrium. The what equilibrium implies that a state of balance, there is no unbalanced potentials are there within the system. So that properties are fixed for that system. So whatever for that state, for that at that moment, the properties need to be fixed. So for thermodynamic, getting a thermodynamic equilibrium, there's three types of equilibriums that we need to achieve. So one is thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium means like the temperature is need to be fixed. That it doesn't change with time. So it got the same value across all the points of the system. Similarly, we got a mechanical equilibrium. So there is no unbalanced forces. The pressure is remain fixed and constant throughout the system at any moment. Then we have got a chemical equilibrium. So no chemical reaction takes place and there is no change in chemical composition of the system. And as you have seen that once if a system undergoes from one state to another state, it undergoes some process. That is a process. So one equilibrium state to another state. To describe a process complete, once you specify the initial state, final state, and the path of the process is needed. So here we have shown a diagram, PV diagram we have plotted for a compression process where the in the cylinder piston pulls the whatever the this system which contain, we take it as a here we take it, that system has is a gas. So this system of this piston cylinder arrangement has a system whose system is nothing just a gas. So what happened, the piston moves the gas inside the cylinder. So what happened, the volume of the gas is decreased and the pressure of the gas is increased. The pressure of the system is system here is a gas, so pressure of the system is decreased. So we got this kind of PV diagram. So here is the initial state. So volume here V1, then we if you compressed that gas, then we reach the final state where the volume is decreased but the pressure is increased. So this system is undergoes a process where the volume is decreased and the pressure is increased. In the next class we'll see what we mean by the cycle, and we also see one quasi-static process. This is the one kind of near equilibrium process. So I have concluded the class, today's class here. Thank you.